So good afternoon everyone. As you know that I have completed your theory syllabus of biology, and I have told you that now we will revise all the chapters. I will give you some question answer, you have to tell me. Like this, I was discussing the chapter, last chapter from that chemical coordination and integration, and in my previous class I have given some questions to solve now, and I have completed up to the hypothalamus, and now today I will start from the pituitary gland. So from the pituitary gland I will give you some fill in the blanks, you have to tell me the answers. With that your revision will be also there, and if you are having any queries related to this portion, tell me. Okay, you can tell me. So I will write it down on the board. Please write it down in your copy and try to solve the answers. As you can see, I have written three questions on the board. So just read the question carefully and tell me the answer one by one. Just first write it down in your copy and solve the questions in your copy, and after that you will tell me the answers. First question. First question is a fill in the blank. That is, pituitary gland is located in a bony cavity called DAS. As you know that pituitary gland is located in a bony cavity, and what is the name of the bony cavity? What should I write on the DAS? Tell me. Tapos, tell me what will be the answer. Anyone? Bhavya, Promit, okay, no one. Okay, let me tell you, the answer is cella turcica. So the answer is cella turcica. So pituitary gland is located in a bony cavity, and the name of the bony cavity is cella turcica. Now come to the next question. What are the different parts of adenohypophysis? What are the different parts of adenohypophysis? So adeno, what will be the answer? Adenohypophysis consists of two portions. What are those two portions? Pars distalis and pars intermedia. Okay, so answer of the next question is pars distalis and pars intermedia. So let me write it down. Pars distalis and pars intermedia is the answer of the second question. Now come to the third question. What are the two divisions of pituitary gland? As you know that pituitary gland is divided in anatomically into two parts. What are they? These two are adenohypophysis or anterior pituitary and neurohypophysis or posterior pituitary. So what will be the answer? Adenohypophysis and neurohypophysis, or what are the alternative names of these two? Anterior pituitary and posterior pituitary. Okay, so now come to the next questions. Is name the hormones which can be produced from anterior pituitary or adenohypophysis. So I am repeating fourth question. What is the question? Name the hormones which can be produced from anterior pituitary. So which hormones can be produced from the anterior pituitary? Anyone? Try to answer, everyone. Name of the hormones which can be produced from the anterior pituitary. So I am telling you what. what are the hormones that can be produced from the anterior pituitary? Growth hormone, prolactin. So I have told you that there is a short trick for remembering the name of the hormones for this one. So what is the short form? That is, this is flat or PG, flat PG. Okay, so after the class 12, whenever you will go to further study, so where you have to stay? You have to stay in a flat or PG. So this flat or PG is the name of the hormones which can be produced from the anterior pituitary. How? Let me tell you. What is F for? FSH. L for AH. A for ACTH. T for TSH. P for prolactin. G for growth. GH. So these are the all hormones that can be produced from anterior pituitary, and this is the short trick of remembering the name of the hormones which can be released from the anterior pituitary. Okay, so just check what are the hormones. FSH, that means follicle stimulating hormone. LH means luteinizing hormone. ACTH means adrenocorticotropic hormone. TSH means thyroid stimulating hormone. PRL means prolactin. Growth hormone GH. Clear? So this is the answer of the question number 4. Now come to the next question, question number 5. DASH hormone can be secreted from pars intermedia. DASH hormone can be secreted from pars intermedia, because only one hormone can be secreted from the pars intermedia. Can you tell me the name of this particular hormone? The name of this particular hormone is MSH, melanocyte stimulating hormone. So the answer will be MSH. Okay, so the answer is MSH, and full form of MSH is melanocyte stimulating hormone. In your examination, you have to write down in the full form and the short abbreviation. If you just write the short abbreviation, your marks, half marks may be deducted. Okay? So this is the answer of this question. Now come to the next question, that is question number 6. Write the name of the hormones released from posterior pituitary. Can you tell me name of the hormones that can be released from the posterior pituitary? Mainly two hormones that can be released from the posterior pituitary are oxytocin and vasopressin. So the answer is oxytocin and vasopressin. Okay, so now come to the next question. I will write it down on the board. blanks. So what is the first question? Dwarfism can be caused by over secretion of DHEAS hormone. Sorry, I have done a mistake. As you know that zygantism can be caused by the over secretion of a hormone, but dwarfism can be caused by the low secretion of the particular hormone. So what is the name of the hormone? It's very easy, that is the growth hormone. So this is the abnormality related to growth hormone. That means if over secretion of growth hormone can be seen in then gigantism can be seen, but if low secretion of the growth hormone is there, then dwarfism will be seen. Okay, so the answer is growth hormone. Now come to the next question. Growth of mammary gland is regulated by DHEAS. Growth of mammary gland is regulated by DHEAS. That means growth of mammary gland will be regulated by which hormone? Can you tell me the answer? Which gland, which hormone regulates the growth of the mammary glands and formation of milk in them? It's a very easy answer. Prolactin. Prolactin. Prolactin regulates the growth of the mammary glands and the secretion of the milk. Now come to the next question. TSH stimulates the synthesis of DHEAS hormone. If you know the full name of this hormone, then it will be very easy to write down the answer this question. So full name is thyroid stimulating hormone. So obviously it will stimulate the thyroid gland to release the hormones from it. So the answer will be thyroid hormones. Now come to the next question. DHEAS is called as gonadotropin. DHEAS is called as gonadotropin. So in this case, as gonadotropin means the hormones which are having role on gonads. So what will be the answer? LH and FSH stimulate gonadal activity, hence these are called as gonadotropin. So LH and FSH both are having role on the gonadal activity, that is why LH and FSH are called as gonadotropins. Okay, and some questions let me ask you. If I ask you that what is the role of ACTH, what is the role of ACTH, then what will be the answer? ACTH stimulates the synthesis and secretion of steroid hormone. That is, the name of this steroid hormone is glucocorticoids, and which can be released from the adrenal cortex. And if I ask you that what is the role of FSH, then the answer will be FSH in males regulate the spermatogenesis. And if I ask you the what is the role of LH, then you have to write down in female, LH induces ovulation of fully mature follicles and maintains the corpus luteum formed from the remnants of Graafian follicle after ovulation. Okay, and if I ask you like this, that what is the role of FSH in male and what is the role of FSH in female? So I have mentioned the role of FSH in male, then what will be the role of FSH in female? That FSH stimulates growth and development of ovarian follicles in females, and in case of males it regulates the process spermatogenesis. Okay, this type of questions may be asked, that what is the role of FSH in both male and female, then you have to write it down separately. Now which hormone, next question, which hormone regulates the pigmentation on the skin? Then the answer will be MSH, melanin containing cell. That means MSH acts on melanocyte, and this can be, and pigmentation can be maintained by this MSH. Okay, and These are the different hormones that can be released from the anterior pituitary. We have seen that different abnormality can be seen if their secretion is quite high and quite low. Okay, like that, from the posterior pituitary, two hormones can be released, that is oxytocin and vasopressin. So, what are the function of these two questions may be asked from this part also. So, this type of question may be asked that what is the role of oxytocin or what is the role of oxytocin in female body, then you have to write down that oxytocin acts on the smooth muscles of our body and stimulates their contraction, and it females a vigorous contraction of the uterus at the time of childbirth and the milk ejection from the mammary gland. So this is the main role of oxytocin. It helps in the childbirth. So it helps in the contraction of the smooth muscles and helps in the parturition. Now last question, that is what is AD, full form of ADH? Full form of ADH, antidiuretic hormone, and it is the alternative name of vasopressin. This part is also important part, you have to remember that this is the alternative name of vasopressin. And what is the role of vasopressin? That it helps in the reabsorption of water and minerals by the DCT, and it helps in the water loss through the urine, and as it is working like that, that is why it is also called as antidiuretic hormone or ADH. So today we have discussed some question answers, some fill in the blanks from the pituitary gland. So in my next class I will discuss about the next other glands. Okay, so thank you everyone, and bye bye for today.